All right, still new criticism from German Chancellor Angela Merkel about U.S. leadership in the world, or frankly, the lack thereof.
She's made three pretty stinging statements in the last 48 hours about the United States. Joining us now with what she said in reaction to it is Nicholas Burns, former U.S. ambassador to NATO and current professor of international relations at Harvard, and Frederick Pleichten, our CNN senior international correspondent who has covered Merkel extensively. So she has now made these three biting statements, nothing being held back.
No, certainly. And it's quite remarkable if you know Angela Merkel, Poppy, and you know that she really isn't someone who says these things lightly. She's someone who chooses her words very carefully. For her to originally make that statement that she feels Germany can't necessarily rely on others anymore, originally make that statement, but then make it again, certainly is quite remarkable. Let's just listen in really quickly to what she said.
The discussions with the United States of America are, of course, important, just as the discussions with other partners. The transatlantic relationship is of incredible importance. And what I said is really just to point out that at the current point in time, there are more reasons than there even were before to take our fate into our own hands within Europe.
So she says at this point in time, which clearly means with this current White House. So what Angela Merkel was saying there is that Germany is still committed to the transatlantic alliance just like it was before. However, they're not entirely sure whether the White House really, or this current White House, really has their back in all aspects. And that, of course, comes right after President Trump was in Europe last week, especially with the NATO summit and some of the criticism at other NATO members. I think that really is something that certainly worries the Germans.
You know, Ambassador, it's not just foreign leaders who seem to be uncertain about where things are headed as well. As people, members of the president's own party, John McCain in Australia, for some speeches, doing some interviews with Australian media, and he flat out said that Americans are unsettled. Listen to this.
I realize that some of President Trump's actions and statements have unsettled America's friends. They've unsettled many Americans as well. There is real debate underway now in my country about what kind of role America should play in the world. And frankly, I don't know how this debate will play out.
Now, he didn't bluntly criticize the president there, Ambassador, but he came very, very close, which is very unusual for a sitting U.S. senator, particularly the president's own party, to do overseas.
Well, I think that we're looking at one of the deepest divisions in the U.S.-European relationship in a generation or two, because what President Trump has essentially done is laid down the gauntlet to the Europeans. He's attacking them verbally with his tweet this morning saying that Germany is a competitor with the United States. Contrast that with his very respectful, quite deferential treatment of the Saudi king and the other Gulf monarchs, none of whom are Democrats, last week. And I think from a European perspective, what we're hearing from Chancellor Merkel, certainly it's good politics for her to distance herself from Donald Trump in an election year. But beyond that, the Europeans believe that President Trump personally is not committed to the European Union and a close US-EU relationship. He would be the very first American president not to commit himself to a unified Europe. We're about to commemorate the Marshall Plan speech here at Harvard on June 4th, 1947, the 70th anniversary. That was all about the Truman administration committing itself to a unified Europe. But Trump's the president who cheered on Brexit, who said nice things about Marine Le Pen. And I think the Europeans feel with the Trump attack on the EU on trade and with his disparaging of NATO last week, they feel that he's not committed to this 70-year relationship that we've had. This is a profound break. It's not a permanent break, but we're looking at a decline of American leadership in Europe unless the Trump administration can right itself and reconsider these irresponsible statements.
So, Ambassador, the Italian Prime Minister just said moments ago, we're just getting this in, a very similar thing to what we're hearing from Angela Merkel and also from the German Foreign Minister. Italy's Prime Minister is saying that the EU, quote, must take its future into its own hands. Now, it's no surprise that there have been tough relations between Angela Merkel and Donald Trump on a personal level. They've traded personal barbs. But is this, how much more is this? Because it seems like You know, she has just certainly let anyone in her government say anything about the United States now. You had the German foreign minister coming out and saying the short-sighted policies of the American government stand against the interests of the European Union. He went on to say those who do not oppose this U.S. policy are guilty, Ambassador.
Well, we're looking at deep divisions on specific issues that are vital to both sides of the Atlantic. We do not agree right now with the Europeans, the Trump administration, on Russia. The Europeans see the president as quite weak on Russia. We don't agree on trade. They want a free trade agreement between the EU and the U.S. The Trump administration does not. We don't agree on climate change. Climate might be the number one issue in Europe on the part of the citizens, and the Trump administration is actively Hamlet-like debating whether or not we should stay in the pact. And then if you don't also exhibit at least a concern about NATO and the EU, a commitment to it on the part of the United States, then you've really thrown the whole basis of the relationship into question. That's why you're seeing this reaction from Europe. And let me just say, it's a two-way street. President Trump's right about European defense spending. They should spend more. But the way he's going about it, trying to shame the Europeans publicly in election years for some of them, not effective.
No, and it seems that the floodgates of criticism have opened up across Europe. Ambassador Burns, Fred Pleichen, thanks so much for being with us. Appreciate it.